Dumelang Sanmalani, hello, hi, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome, welcome Tase. And if you're a regular degular, I appreciate you so much. Sana, it's funny how I came on here because I'm trying to avoid noise, but it seems like noise is following me. If it's not my kids, it's the people outside suddenly wanting to come and play by the gate. Why? There was no one when I was sitting here all alone. But it's fine. We shall continue. So I decided to do a mini get to know me tag, and I asked ChatGPT for questions because, well, who am I gonna ask? You guys, you don't respond. I'm joking. But anyway, I asked ChatGPT for some questions for a get to know me tag. Let's start. Question number one, what is your full name? My name is Muhle Sinothando Magwentshu. I prefer to be called Sino though. Like, simply Sino is fine. You can just say Sino. Yeah, simply Sino is not, the simply is not necessary. You can just say Sino. So it's Sino. Where am I from? I am from the Eastern Cape. Elalini kuthiwa kuseLusikisiki. Born and bred there. Moved to Johannesburg 2005 when I was 9 years old. Yeah. How old am I? I'm 28. I am 28, baby, and I ate. Okay. I don't know why I keep saying that. Every time someone asks me how old I am, I'm gonna be like, I'm 28 and I ate. Okay, because I feel like this is my year for eating. Regardless, like eating not financially or anything else, but I'm eating my body, my face. I'm feeling my best self. Okay. So I'm eating, Kasana, I ate. What is my favorite color? I don't really have a favorite color. I used to think I like gray, but I realized I liked gray because it was more of a really have a favorite color right now, but I think I'm falling into the trap of liking pink because I see a lot of cute pink stuff recently. I don't know why, but yeah, the girl is saying nice pink stuff. And then my favorite food. My favorite food. What do I like? I like burgers. I like McDonald's, like McFeast. In fact, I don't like McFeast. I love spicy McFeast with my all. And if I was to talk about a whole meal, I would say papa ne kapechu and tin fish. That is my favorite meal. Do I have any siblings? Oh my gosh, I have got siblings for the whole world. I have got siblings to cater for everybody who does not have a sibling. Like, you can come and take anyone from mine. I'm kidding. I have got 11 siblings. There are four boys. No, not four. So it's these three boys and the other. So it's six boys and no, seven boys and four girls. Yes, seven boys and four girls. Those are my siblings that I have. In total, there's 12 of us. And was my favorite hobby. My favorite hobby, which I am slowly turning into a business, is YouTube. I really, in fact, not even just YouTube, content creation. Oh my gosh, I hope they're not too loud. Because, what the hell? They were not here, guys. Why are they making a noise? Okay. My favorite hobby, like I said, content creation. And what is my favorite movie? My favorite movie to this date, I don't have one. I think I've got two. It's Man on Fire, all-time favorite, and I've recently started to like A Miracle in Cell Number 7. It brings out all the tears that I need to come out. So best believe, when I'm watching A Miracle in Cell Number 7, I need to cry. And what is your biggest pet peeve? My biggest pet peeve, someone who spits when they talk. Ugh. Why? Oh yeah, no, that's my biggest pet peeve, and it has to do with the oral, man. Yeah, the oral. I cannot for the life of me What is my favorite childhood memory? I'm gonna have to think about that one. My favorite childhood memory is Oh, it would have to be the very first time that I cooked for my grandmother. I know, guys, it's a chore, but the very first time that I cooked for my grandmother, who is my mother's mom, that day she was sitting. I remember that day so well. She was sitting in the sofa, and I was like, "Relax, makhulu, send your wazo pack. I'm gonna cook for you, girl." And I cooked for her, and we had conversations. I told her my dreams. I told her what I'd love to do for her and all of that. Of course, I didn't get to do all those things for her because she left literally a year after I matriculated. But yeah. What is your zodiac sign? I don't really believe in star signs, but I am a Gemini. I don't really believe in them though. What do I do for a living? I am media liaison specialist. And I'm also a content creator. And I'm also a podcaster. And I'm also a business owner. That's what I do for a living. And what is my biggest fear? My biggest fear is I've got two fears, and they're all centered around one thing. That would be me leaving my kids while they are still young and not independent. Or one of my kids leaving me. I don't think I'd be able to bear that. And yeah. What is my favorite book? Guys, I'm not really a reader. I really don't read. I really don't read. But I would say Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I finished that book in a day and a half. That's how good it was. And We're Gonna Need More Wine by Gabrielle Union. I think Rich Dad Poor Dad is by Robin Mang Mang. I don't know, but I'll put the person's details there. What is my dream travel destination? My dream travel destination would be to go to. Where would I love to go? Nah. Where would I love to go? I think I would love to go to Mauritius. I really think I would love, like, really, really love to. If not Mauritius, then Thailand. Yeah, those two. Who is your biggest inspiration? I've got different people who inspire me for different things. So when it comes to content creation, the people who inspire me, I would say one, Grace Mondlana inspires me, both her and Lerato Nxumalo. I know the current trend with the two of them, but and I realized that trend made me realize that the reason why I like both of them for that specific part is because they create similar content, and I like them because they show vlogging in a different way. They make it feel natural. It doesn't feel like work. Doesn't feel like a lot was edited. It just feels like every single time a person picked up the camera, they said the exact same thing that like the exact thing that they wanted to say. And yeah. So I would say for content creation in terms of vlogging, it would be Grace Mondlana and Lerato Nxumalo. And also there's a guy by the name of Tiye or T Sithole. I don't know how to pronounce his name, but also him. Oh, angles, baby. So those are my three inspirations when it comes to content creation. And then when it comes to business, ne, I would say there is a lady who's from my church who I follow on Facebook. Her name is Sinazo Mpomane. I think her surname is Mpomane, but I know that her name is Sinazo. Oh, she inspires me on all angles because, wow, how are you able to do so much and still be able to live and still be able to be a mother to your kids? It's honestly amazing, amazing. I love that about her. And then who else inspires me now? Yeah, I think those are the people, honestly. Those are the two people, well, the two different industries that I'm inspired in. And then who inspires me in life as a whole? I don't know. I don't know. What is my favorite way to relax? I think my favorite way to relax, the thing is, I think after having kids, I haven't ever had the chance to fully relax. So maybe I would say going out, is that a way of relaxing? I don't know. Because I feel like when I go out, that's when I get to just live. Yeah. Oh, what are your YouTube goals? My YouTube goals. It depends. Which plan do you want? Do you want the long-term plan or do you want the short-term plan? Short-term plan is to get monetized by the end of the year. Monetized by the end of the year would mean reaching 1,000 subscribers, which I'm currently halfway to. Reaching 3,000, I mean, sorry, 4,000 watch hours, which I'm quite far from, but I am hopeful that it will happen. So those are my short-term goals. And then my lifelong goals would be for me to quit my job and make money from YouTube. That would, yeah, like make enough money on YouTube only, apart from Instagram. Apart from the Instagram brand collaborations and stuff like that, but I want to make enough money on Insta on I mean on YouTube. For me to be able to take care of myself. Yeah, literally. That would be my goal. Also, I've got two channels. The other channel, which is the podcast channel, my goals for that channel are really not monetary. They're not attached to numbers. But, you know, I would love to one day get a story or get feedback from someone saying, you know, a few months back or a year ago, I watched a video with one of your guests, and this is how it changed my life. I do it because I wish, and I just wanted to reach people and make a difference in people's lives. That's my I feel like it would be my way of contributing to a better society through that podcast channel. Yeah. And then, what is the most rewarding thing about being a mom of two girls? I think honestly, the most rewarding thing is that I get to experience life, or I get to experience the life that I sort of wish that I had, or I think the life that I sort of want through them. I don't know if that makes sense to anyone, but yeah, I get to do things that I wish had been done for me with them. And I think that's a thing with every parent. Not that maybe you weren't raised well or your parents didn't take care of you, but it's just that thing, Yoguti, you want bigger and better things for your kids, and being there to experience that, being there to experience, to see how my kids are such happy souls. Oh, they are such happy souls, and I think that's amazing. That is the most rewarding thing for me, seeing how happy they are and knowing that I'm a contributing factor to that. It means I have, or I am doing what God has set out for me to do with them. Yeah. How do I balance content creation with motherhood? I don't. I really don't balance it. I just live life. And for now, because I'm pushing so many things, I'm pushing the business, I'm pushing the podcast, I'm pushing this channel. It's quite a lot, but I think it's gonna be worth it in the end. What are your daughter's favorite things about being a part of your content creation journey? I think their favorite thing is them thinking that they're famous. I know, but my daughters think and feel like they're famous, and yeah, I think they really enjoy seeing me create content, and I see that through them creating content themselves. Anyone who has been here knows that Emily will randomly take the camera and vlog for people, and she'll always say, "Welcome to my YouTube channel" and stuff like that. So I guess it's sort of, yeah, I don't know how to best describe it. How do I make time for my own passions and hobbies? I think having a support structure kind of assists in this one because I've got amazing siblings, and whenever I need to do my stuff or whenever I need time out, my siblings are always there to take care of my babies. So yeah, I think having a support structure has assisted me a lot. Okay? A lot. How do you involve your daughters in your vlogs and content? It's not a how sort of question. They are just a part of it. And I know that it's advised to not show your kids on the internet and stuff like that, especially on YouTube, because apparently there is a policy for it. I haven't gone and checked it out because I feel like it would make me so conscious that I wouldn't even be able to enjoy the content that I create anymore. So what I have decided upon myself and upon my life is that with the policies there or not there, if I'm meant to have this channel, then YouTube is not going to punish me for being a mom vlogger. Yeah, that's a decision that I've made for myself. What's the most memorable trip that I've taken with my girls? I think the most memorable trip was when we went to church, eGqeberha. I know it's church and stuff like that, but it was the first time that my kids got to experience traveling with a bus, sleeping at a hotel. Was it their first time? I think it was their first time sleeping at a hotel. It was their first time at a stadium. That trip was a first of many things for them, and I got to be there. And to this day, Uemihle remembers eGqeberha. She remembers seeing the mountains. She remembers seeing the ocean. And for the longest time, she was not happy because she didn't get to go to the ocean, and I did. But luckily, again, this year when we went to Durban, she got to go to the ocean. So she's over that now. But yeah, that is the most memorable trip that I can say I have had with them. What's one thing you wish more people understood about being a single mom? I wish more people understood that nobody falls pregnant, or I would like to assume, because that is my case, nobody falls pregnant wanting to be a single mother. Nobody wants to do this alone. It's not easy. It's not easy when the kids want things or want communication with other parties. It's not easy when you have to answer questions that even you don't have answers to. It's not easy. It's not easy doing it alone. You might have the support structure from family and all of that, but it still doesn't take away from the fact that you're doing it alone. And nobody, I don't think anybody would want to ever experience that, having to go to graduations alone, having to go to the doctor alone, having to go everything, man, everything. It's not an easy job, but I think it's a really rewarding job in the end when the kids are all grown, and that's what keeps me going. I know there isn't a question here about what keeps me going when it comes to being a single mother, but that's what keeps me going. The fact that I know that my kids are gonna do well in life and they're gonna stay happy, and I will have been responsible for that. I will have solely been responsible for that. I'm not gonna be bragging about it to the other party or anything like that, but I will be at peace knowing the fact that I did everything that I could to ensure that these kids have got a bright, beautiful, successful and happy future. What the other party would then be feeling or doing, only God knows. Only God knows. So yeah, Ilanga is fading away. But I would say also people need to be more lenient on single mothers. Me being a single mother does not, what was I saying? I've lost my train of thought. But yeah, guys, that is a mini get to know me. Or let me actually look for more questions. Another question is, do I see myself having more kids? Alone? No. Like I said, guys, nobody ever plans to have kids and be a single mom. But I think this time around, I would only want to have any other kid in marriage. But I mean, it wouldn't be a problem to get a husband who has got two boys. I mean, blended family. Perfect for me. Honestly, that would be perfect for me. Blended family vibes. Obviously, this then brings me to, would I get married? Would I get married? Honestly, I'm two ways in it. I believe in love. I believe in happily ever after. But my experiences or what I've seen through married people doesn't make me want to get married. Because I feel like I've experienced enough hardships and I don't need to experience those hardships with a ring on my finger. A ring on my finger is not going to be symbolizing that I've made it and stuff like that. So I don't know. Would I want to get married? I'd love to. I think I would love to get married. But it's going to have to take God for me to get married. When I say it's going to have to take God, God would have had to bring that partner to me. I know most people are probably like, yeah, well, we get married because God sent that person to us. But it needs to... Shoo. Hey, guys, it's quite a deep one for me. But I guess the crux of it all is, yes, I would love to get married to the right person, God willingly. Do I have any tattoos? Yes, I do have one tattoo. Planning on getting another one before the end of the year. Not sure what I'm going to get, but I plan on getting another tattoo. What do I believe in? God or the ancestors? Or am I atheist? Definitely not atheist. I believe in the balance of God and the ancestors. I don't know how true that is, that you can, there can be a balance, because Christians will tell you that God is the only way. Traditional people will tell you that ancestors are the only way. But I believe, like, I'm in the middle. For now, I am in the middle. And yeah, my favorite restaurants for now, it's McDonald's. What is my favorite subject in school? I think I enjoyed business studies. I just didn't give myself, or I didn't feel like I enjoyed it, because I was too, I wanted to become an accountant so much that I wanted accounting to be my favorite subject, and accounting wasn't accounting me. Why did I start YouTube? I started YouTube because for almost 5 years before I started my YouTube channel, I enjoyed watching other people create content, and I learned, like, I literally learned through Usnim Shongo and ZX Online, y'all's channel, that this is something that is doable, and I thought I can do it. I was scared for the longest time, but then one day I woke up and I was like, it's Vlogmas, so let me just do it. And I uploaded my first episode on the 2nd of December, which was Vlogmas episode 1. Yeah. My favorite artist. My favorite artist locally would be Loiso. And yeah, I don't have another one. I guess Loiso, yeah. I think Loiso is my favorite artist and my favorite content creator. There are so many of them. But my favorite content creator when it comes to big YouTubers would be, or even big content creators, I would say is, shoo. Let's have three sections, like the big YouTubers. I would say I will always and forever love K-Yams. And medium big, Nyana. I don't know what medium big is, but the like 50K and below content creators would be the Millennial Mom and Wipilo K. And then the smaller YouTubers would be, I really like the content that Millicent M creates, how she incorporates finance into her vlogs, like the financial education and still vlogging type of content. I really like it. I also like Kels Mabula. I feel like, I don't know. I feel like if I would meet Kels, her and I would automatically, I think we'd both be awkward on the like the first time that we meet, but the second time we just naturally become like we think that we are each other's best friends. I also like really like Busisiwe Nyalunga. Yeah, those are the people that I would say I really enjoy their content. And yeah, guys, that is literally, why do I keep wanting to drag this and asking myself more questions? No, girl, this is already long enough. But yeah, that is my YouTube get to know me. If you feel like you've got a question that I didn't answer that you would make you get to know me a bit more, please don't be shy to ask it in the comment section down below. And I will either answer it in another video or I will respond in the comment. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you feel like you have enough time or you're not busy, I have got playlists on my YouTube account. Kindly, please, please play them. Like, just play them. You can play them on low volume or mute, whatever. Just play them for me, please. Because I'm trying to get monetized. And I need the hours. Yeah. Bye. See you in the next one.